Hey everyone, Daniel here from TwinBytes with another quick tutorial for you. This time on the email address autocomplete contacts. If you're not familiar what that is, it's when you go to create a new email. As soon as you click in here to type in an email address, it automatically shows some recent people that you've contacted. As you start spelling out somebody's name, it filters it out to show those people with the similar name that you've contacted recently. What people mostly don't know is that there's a limit to 1,000 addresses that are contained in here, and it keeps deleting the oldest ones you haven't used and making room for the new ones to appear. So unless you go into the address book and go in to create a new contact, they're not going to be in your Outlook in order for you to back up. So when you do your backups of your emails, it's not going to include the contacts, and you're going to find out when it's too late that all your contacts are gone. So if you want to keep them, you're going to want to save them in your address book, because otherwise it's a long, tedious process to back up and restore them, which you're going to find out in this video. So there's two methods of backing up and restoring your contacts. One is if you're on an old version of Outlook 2007 or before, which hopefully nobody is. So we're going to assume you're on a newer version now. Or if you're using a POP email account, and I'm not going to get into explaining what all these things are, but if it's a POP account, you'll have what's called an NK2 file. And you can browse to this location on your computer and just copy that file. And of course your computer has to be working at that time, or recover that file in one method or another, and then simply paste that file in the same location on your new computer or on the same computer after it's been formatted in a fresh install of Windows and Office. If you're not using POP and it's one of these other type of accounts, such as a Microsoft 365, Exchange Server, or IMAP, then it's going to be using a database type format, which I'm going to show you how to do that here. There's a link in the description as well to this website that tells you exactly how to go through this process, although the steps may have changed slightly. The first thing they tell you is to click on the link to take you to this website and to run an executable, which we do not see here. Things have changed a little bit, so what you want to do is click on the April 2017 release, and by the time you see this video it may change again, but you're looking for the release of the MFC MAPI. When we click into that, scroll down a bit, there's a few options. We're looking for an executable and it's of the MFC MAPI. Now you got to make sure that you choose the right one depending on the version of Outlook you're using. If you're using a 32-bit version, which most likely you are, you're going to want that one. Otherwise, if it is 64-bit, you've got to make sure you choose this version. Otherwise, this process is not going to work. I'm going to click on the 32-bit and I'm going to open that and run through it. Simply extract the file and open it. It gives you a dialog box that comes up. You can hit OK on there. Then you want to go into open the session menu here and then go to Logon. Choose your email account that's associated with the account that you're trying to back up the emails for and hit OK. In the top here, you want to find the line that corresponds to your email account. If you need to, you can expand this to make it a little bit bigger, and I can see my account over here and highlight that. What you want to do is double click on it and you get another window up here. You've got the root container, so we want to expand that, and this is where the instructions will start to vary from on the website which I'm linking to. It says to go to the top of the information store or the IPM subtree. We don't really have any of those things here. There's top of Outlook data file, so we can click into there and expand that. Then you want to find the inbox, and I left click on everything first before right clicking on it, but really you just need to right click on the inbox folder and then click on open associated content table. you have another window again that opens, and what you want to do is look under the subject column. So we'll have to scroll over a bit here and make that bigger so we can actually see. And you want to look for IPM configuration autocomplete. And we happen to have that right here. And you want to right click on that and go to export message. So this is telling you that it's going to save this to a text file. Now the instructions are just saying that it opens up asking you to save the file, but you want to go in the drop down menu here and select the MSG Unicode, and then you can hit OK. This is where you get to choose where you want to back it up to. So once you found where you want to save it to, because you got to remember where it is so you can find it again later, save that and OK and OK again, and that's it. You can then close all these other windows and you now have your contacts backed up. Now to restore your backed up copy of the autocomplete list, we're going to do a similar thing kind of in a backwards manner. So you're going to get the same file, which you can go through and download again, or if you already have a copy of that, just copy and paste it to your new computer or restore that to your computer after you've rebuilt it. We're going to run that file. Okay, the splash message here. We want to go to session and log on again like we did before and select our account. Because of course you want to have your account set up at that time before restoring it. Otherwise it's got nowhere to restore it to. We'll make this a bit bigger so we can find our account that we're looking for. And we'll double click on that. And we want to drill down through the root container again. Top of information store, which the wording is a little different. Top of Outlook data file. You want to right click on the inbox and open associated contents table. This opens up another window. Again, we're going to have to scroll over here and expand the subject field. You want to look for the IPM configuration autocomplete and see if it exists. If you haven't sent any emails yet from this newly configured email account, then you may not have this autocomplete file yet, which is fine. But if you do have it in here, you're going to want to delete it first so you can right click and delete the message. From the drop down menu, you want to go to permanently delete, and then you can hit OK. So that should be gone, so you do not have your autocomplete. Now from the same window, after deleting it, you can go up to folder and import MSG. Find the file that you backed up, and you want to open that. And the default option in the drop-down menu is correct. Load message into current folder. And then OK. Now you should see the autocomplete is in that list again. And that's it to backing up and restoring the autocomplete email addresses in Microsoft Outlook. So you can see why it's very complicated, and you need to make sure that anyone you want to keep in your address book, you save them specifically to your address book. Otherwise, to back them up is not that easy. You have to go through this process in order to back them up and restore them each time. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please do give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you in future videos. Thanks so much. Bye for now.